guests for this evening. It's me. Rising group from Liverpool called the Beatles. Of course, this was the show at which John Lennon said, just before they played Twist and Shout, he said, for the last number, we'd like you to all clap along and the rest of you can rattle your jewellery. The next day, even though I was very young, the next day the newspapers in England were like, the world was ending. Nobody had ever spoken so insolently to the royal family before. Particularly the Daily Mail, any reason to get indignant was even then something that they could make a lot of copy out of. And so nobody really remembers that at number 12 on the bill, five places above the Beatles, my father sang If I Had a Hammer for the Queen. The Queen Mother was very fond of work songs, never really having had a job of her own, And it was an unusual thing, to say the least, that my father would be on television when I was a lad, because while my friends were in their bedroom and their parents were knocking on the door going, turn that bloody music down, my father was in the front room learning that bloody music so he could sing it on the radio. And they had to sing the hits of the day with the dance band. So one week he'd be singing Little Arrows by Leapy Lee. And the next week he'd be singing See Emily Play by the Pink Floyd or Substitute by the Who. I know that sounds really weird that a dance band like that would play those songs, but that was the way it was. So, as the 60s wore on, he decided that he didn't want to sing with the dance band anymore, and he decided to quit and become a solo singer, take a message of peace and love and tolerance to the working men of England, Scotland and Wales. He couldn't really care less about the rest of the people in Ireland, but because because they'd made us leave there, like we were economic migrants, so he went there occasionally, I'm kidding. But he did change his appearance very radically from a smart and debonair crooner who'd had his glasses stolen in a futile attempt to make him look conventionally handsome, to somebody who looked like Peter Sellers in What's New Pussycat. Or for the younger people in the audience, Austin Powers. he even formed a little bit of a hippie group on the side called the Hand Embroidered Lemon Peel. I don't think they actually made any records. I think it was just an excuse for him to seduce hippie girls, So he was a little bit of a bad man. So all the way through my teenage years, I was listening to Rocksteady and Tamla Motown while he's listening to the Jefferson Airplane. And it was quite confusing. The generation gap was very different in our house. And so by the time I was 17, I learned to play the guitar a little bit. We made peace about it, and I went with him to help him carry his equipment because it was 5 inches taller than me. And I carried his trumpet. And we went to a place in the northwest of England called Blackpool. Now, when you live in a landlocked paradise like Zurich, it's hard for me to summon up the majesty that is Blackpool. It's kind of like Las Vegas, only without the sun, or really the sin in those days. There's just 5 sad donkeys tied to a post to scare children, and a big long beach, and a pier that disappears, and at the very end of it, a telescope through which you may occasionally see the sea. At the end of the day, the parents are dragging the kids off the shore, off the beach, and they're all pink and screaming, and they're full of pickled onions and fish and chips and pop. And they drag them to a boarding house or a hotel and shove them into bed and go to a nightclub to hear my dad sing the Ray Stevens hit, "Everything is Beautiful." I'm behind the curtain, ready to sit in with the band for the first time ever. And the organist, who was a man, probably only about 45, but he had a face that was at least 76. He had a plume of ash on a cigarette and went out like that. And I tried to get in tune, and he said, "De ala," and he played a note. I think it was a Q flat. It's known in any scale. Can't even hear this note. And so when the curtain started to rise, my father turned around to me and he had a look in his eye, and that look said, "Don't fuck up." But as the music started to play, I realized I was completely out of tune with the band. There was no way for me to adjust. I didn't know enough about the guitar. So I got the volume control and I turned it right off. And I played the show of my life. After a couple of numbers, I kind of got a little bit flash, you know. It was a perfect preparation for being in pop music. I met a lot of people, a lot of strange people in those clubs. There were lots of desperate people. There were people that really shouldn't have been in show business. There were really some people that really shouldn't have been out of the house without a note from their mother. I started to write this song about them when I was 17, and I finished it while I was walking around the lake today, so I'd like to play it. Maureen and Stan was looking for a job. They got songs for every occasion and a little limelight robbery, but no one will imply that there's nothing to his sign. He autographs his overdraft as she goes out of her mind. Stuck on the wall with a thousand faces, unwanted posters and haunted places. Roll out with a ghost train non-stop through the city. Step right up and show your face, only want the pretty ones. Roll out with a ghost train non-stop through the city. Step right up. Up in the sink, laughing and singing, dressed up like dice. Maybe they could freeze to death out there on the ice. Look at the graceful way she dances. One foot speaks, the other answers. Roll out with the ghost train non-stop through the city. Step right up and show your face. Boy, what the pretty ones. Roll out with the ghost train. Stop through the city. Step right up and show your face. Only want the pretty ones. She plays the queen of the feet pit. He plays the got a black eye from a waitress. She's not seeing it as stars. You can be refused and you can be replaced. You can change your name, but you can't change your face. And as they make believe it's just another holiday, they turn on each other as they hear that joker say, roll up in a ghost train, non-stop through the city. Step right up and show your face with only one of the pretty ones. Roll up in a ghost train, non-stop through the city. Step right up.